tree. Now fuck that bitch, need to feel it. Made me so damn mad, made me feel it. I won't never give you time to breathe. I won't never give a fuck if you breathe. I don't really give a fuck about you. You need a chill, you need to breathe. I'ma ask you to leave. Yeah, my money's so deep.
I was out the... Alright, y'all. Welcome back to a brand new video. It is week 2. Yeah. I just got done flying to Orlando. Damn, this shit is hella close, bro.
Oh, no, you're good.
Okay. Just got done flying to Orlando to do like a one-day qualifying meet to register for powerlifting America so we can be good to compete at junior national main leagues. It's the beginning of week 2 right now. About to hop into some bench press. Sit back and enjoy.
This guy, I'm pissed.
Who?
The motherfucking carpet guy. Dude, I'm fucking Aladdin, okay? Call me Aladdin from now on.
You're not Aladdin. You're fucking, you're Jasmine.
Well, I'm just waiting for the story that says, if you're the best on bench, you better be putting it away. On the 21st Barbell Instagram.
Yeah. No, but somebody started benching right after me on Friday, and that's why I didn't put it away.
He didn't want the carpet.
Yeah, no one.
You were just like, you got the carpet, right? And he didn't say anything.
Yeah. I actually didn't even say that. I didn't even.
Can you put the bench on?
Stop being a bad person.
For 5 years, you've never ever not been a bad person.
You've been a bad person your entire life, okay? I I'm trying to gaslight me into saying that we didn't put, or the owner didn't put up new signs everywhere in the gym because people were coming in and disrespecting the facility. So we had to put on the walls over here, on the door, over by the cable machine, on the floor, on the wall right there. It's because this past couple months, more and more people have been coming to this gym now. And we need to fucking...
Sign says, please put your carpets away.
Yeah, I didn't put the carpet away Friday.
Well, that's how you stop being a bad person, Sean.
Yeah, I know. The signs literally have my name on it, telling me to stop fucking around.
Angles.
Oh my god, bro. Alright, y'all. So we finished up the workout right here. Ended up with 397 on a week 2, which is really good. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. That's probably my heaviest and fastest week 2 bench press. And I'm in volume right now. Is that rain?
Yeah.
God damn, man. But yeah, we're gonna be back tomorrow with squats. I forget what we have, but we're gonna bring the energy regardless. Take it easy.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Hey. Y'all are streaming?
No, we're recording for the YouTube, and then I'm about to stream off my laptop. Hey. This is a special guest, Roscoe.
Well,
I know, yeah, that's not the stream, but...
Yeah, I'm going to stream on the laptop. And
bro,
then,
well,
I'm
gonna,
what's the camera going to be?
It's going to be the laptop camera. Perfect.
Dude, I have a whole setup.
I know. I'm testing it today to see if like people are actually interested in tuning in or not.
Yeah.
And then assuming people start like coming to this, we'll just upgrade the equipment.
I think the thing is like they're gonna join it and then they're gonna leave. And you need to have retention rate, so you gotta have good quality.
Good quality.
Dude, I think you're right.
High quality.
Also, I think my laptop's dead, which I like.
How the fuck did that happen?
No, no, he didn't help me though. It's now working.
Bro? I literally walked over there.
I just turned it off and turned it back on, and now it's working.
Yeah, but what was
it? My son was here.
No, his dad was here.
Little baby boy.
Oh my god. Okay, so we were trying to stream our workout for the boys Discord. If y'all haven't joined, join through the link in my bio. It's just a community that I'm growing there just for me to get the chance to become more personal with you guys, get to know you guys a bit better, just form like a tighter knit community outside of just Instagram. But I wanted to stream my workout for you guys, and it wasn't working for the longest time. It wasn't detecting my microphone, and now all of a sudden it just started working out of nowhere. So I don't know what happened. Hey.
Yeah, my sound showed up. That's what. No, your dad fixed it.
No,
you
no,
needed
no.
help from your dad.
No. But yeah, so it's working now, so we're about to set up.
Goddamn.
Motherfucking Jamal in the building.
Hey. They're talking?
Yeah.
They speak, yes.
Hey guys, guess what?
Just say it.
Chicken butt.
Bro.
Bro.
We're getting Jamal up on out of here.
I didn't guess that one, to be honest. That came out of nowhere.
In the video?
Yeah.
Make Steve do it.
Steve always does it.
What do you do now?
Huh?
What do you do?
No, I was gonna tell Steve to open the video.
Oh, open it?
Yeah.
You open it.
You open it. I don't wanna open it.
Steve, we need you to open the video.
Joe Wee couldn't open it?
Yeah, he couldn't open it. He told.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back to the vlog. My name's Joe Wee. Today is squat. It's primary. We're gonna be working up to 600 pounds on the squat or something like that. Let's run it. Yeah. That was trash.
Yeah. Bad person.
No,
you're just a bad person for not opening the vlog.
Oh.
Honestly, I caught it for you.
I had to step in for you.
I did what you could.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes, you know, sometimes you do it yourself. Sometimes you get your son to do it. It is what it is.
I mean, you couldn't do it yourself, so your dad had to do it.
No, I'm your dad.
No.
I offload my responsibility.
Nope. I don't know about that.
Oh, dude, the back actually hurts a lot.
Loaded. This is 501 pounds on the barbell. This is an American record attempt. If successful, we'll place him in first place. Let's go, Jamal. Give it up for Jamal.
So this is like the first sample of the worker hat. Essentially, the manufacturer was supposed to send me a different sample, but just sent me another of the same one, like a duplicate of this. So I just gave it to Dion since he's the designer for worker. So we are the only two people right now with the only two worker hats in existence. The other ones are coming soon. They're in production right now for you guys. But like, this is like, these are like pieces of history right here that will never be recreated, ever.
This is
Okay, so forgot to say this earlier, but starting with this episode, leading into the next 7-8 weeks, this is going to be the official start to the prep series for PA Junior Nats, road to PA Junior Nats. Every episode is gonna kind of build off each other, since every week, week to week, we're just gonna have to be building on what we did the week beforehand and setting ourselves up for big week threes, big week fours, just building into the meet, because meet prep is all about momentum. So throughout this meet prep, we're gonna show you guys some different ways outside of just the gym that we're doing to stack ourselves up for bigger sessions down the line and just being the best athlete that we possibly can come meet day. So I'm gonna be doing more to record what I've been eating, what my recovery is like, what I'm doing on a day-to-day basis, so we can overlay that with the training so you guys get a whole more well-rounded picture as to what's been going on. But just excited, because this meet prep is for everything, and there's no other way I'd spend it rather than just bringing you guys along for it, really just being able to document the whole thing for you guys. But yeah, we finished with 651 squat today, 551 for a set of eight, and then 485 for another set of eight. Week two, so we're gonna have to be doing everything we can to ramp it up for weeks three and four. But outside of that, we'll catch you guys for deadlifts come Thursday.
Yo, hey.
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 I got the flashback.
Dude, literally flashback.
How are you? Doing great.
I guess I should say what's up to the YouTube.
Yeah, too. True with that.
What's going on, y'all? It is Thursday. Week two. God, I forgot track of what week it was. But I didn't get some deadlifts right now. We pulled up later today as opposed from earlier, just because I think I just want to get back to my nighttime, like, locked in sessions where I'm just, there's no distractions, you know what I mean? But sit back and enjoy, and let's see what we can do.
Oh my god.
When I went back down to grab my 315 for the 694 for the top set, I just like, I gripped it, but I wasn't locked in enough where like, at lockout, it just like slipped out from out. I really don't know how. That doesn't ever happen for loads of that light, but me and just wants me to make sure when I like set my grip, it's like locked in and it's not going nowhere. So make sure that we're doing that. All my top steps doing this one and I'll come back down. And just give me the best. What today told me, relative to when we look at last week four and the secondaries and the loads that we were putting on the secondary week four deadlift and the week three deadlift, what today told me and how I felt today tells me that as we get closer to the meet, like a week or two out, probably like a week out, we need to remove the intensity, lower the intensity on the Saturday before so that I feel like Superman going into the actual meet week.
So we'll chill. You
should do that. Yeah. We'll chill and then meet week I'm gonna feel unlocked.
Because I can't feel the fatigue for you. I just see what you're doing on the secondary.
Yeah.
But I think you should do that.
Yeah, we'll do that. It'll be good.
Power.
Perfect.
Oh, change of grip.
That hurts.
You're the hardest worker.
I swear. But, God damn. Let's cut down those rows. We're gonna do a little bit of, hammer curls, some core, get up on out of here. And that'll be it. It's a good workout overall. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I wish, we tried best to encapsulate the vibe for this session, but I missed deadlifting on Thursday nights, man. The vibes are just different. It's hard to describe, but like there's just like another level of focus behind everything you're doing because gym's usually a bit more calm. You can control the arcs, control everything really, and just enjoy it. I'm definitely gonna look back at this period of time that we're having right now years from now and be like, damn, that was a good ass time. Right now what I'm wearing should be the final run of samples going into the launch. So we're aiming for the first worker drop to be around 6 weeks from now, hopefully. But right now I'm wearing the final iteration of the samples of the first drop, just two of the pieces. We have 7 items coming total. Right here is the cropped 3/4 sleeve tee with the small arc logo. Small details that I'm adding to the clothing. The seams are inverted. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but prior to me getting any worker samples back in around December when I started to rebrand myself, I started wearing all my t-shirts inside out. So the seams would be showing like this. And that's just like a small Easter egg that I wanted to start doing to kind of prelude what was coming with worker. So yeah, we have the seams inverted, a small arc logo, distressed details on the hems, and then on the back I have the worker logo stitched onto the back. So it's almost kind of like a tee that's constructed inside out, but like this is the right way to wear it. And then in addition to that, I have these are the first ever worker mesh performance shorts with the bigger arc logo right here. And then I wanted to upgrade just the quality of the string that we use just because I don't like the white strings that I have on my other shorts. So we decided to go with more of like this twisted yarn look that just I think ties together the look better. But yeah, I got more pieces coming as well, and I'll slowly start to unveil them and leak to you guys them more little by little. But this is honestly like my favorite fit. I've been wearing it all day while I was around the apartment just doing work. And I don't know, I feel so good in the clothes. Like, I've been wearing all black for a minute now, so this is like right up my alley, and I love this stuff. Like, this is, worker is the only thing I plan to wear from this point going forward. But yeah, we're gonna hit a couple more sets, and then get up on out of here. And then after this set, can we just do a couple flash photos?
Yeah.
Perfect. Oh man. Alright y'all, so that wrapped up the YouTube video right here. Good ass week too. We're around 6 weeks, 6 to 7 weeks out from PA Junior Nationals. We have a lot of work to do, but I'm excited for you guys to follow along for the journey. If you guys enjoyed the video, I appreciate you guys tuning in. Seriously, the love that I've been receiving on the YouTube recently and just the social medias in general has had me just feeling so grateful for the people that actually care to tune in and just keep up with what I got going on. But without further ado, like I said, thank you guys so much for everything. Like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.